Hello everyone! In this video, I'm going to show you how to use a variables feature. This feature allows you to combine translations that have similar but not identical content into a single one. For example, if you have repetitive content such as order 1, order 2, order 3, or your website displays the same message with only the name part changing such as hello John, hello Mary, etc., then you can use the variables feature to reduce your word count. Let's see how you can set up a variable to understand it better. First, click on the three-line icon next to one of the translations with the repetitive content to open the See Details panel, and click on Variables. Then click on the Define Variables text here to create one. Here, we need to highlight the part of the text that we want to turn into a variable, so I'll choose the name as it's the varying part in my translations. Then we'll name the variable and choose its name. I'll name mine customer name, but you can name it however you like. And then choose the type as alphabetical only because the variable consists of letters and click on add. Then the preview here will confirm that your variable is valid and show the matching translations. Beware that these matching translations will be deleted once you click save and you'll only have the initial translation that contains the variable. Check our FAQ document below to learn more about the variables feature. So this was it for our tutorial. You can always reach out to us at support@weglot.com if you ever need help. Until next time, bye!